This is the only footage I managed to film close to the G20 summit meeting building before I was pounced on by security. Even when I moved back several hundred metres, I was approached again on a public street and told not to film the Brisbane Convention Centre. Well, this is Musgrave Park behind me where the protesters will be based, and we just slowly swing the camera around here. And if you look down that road, you can see at the end of the road there is the white dome building there. That's the Brisbane Entertainment and Convention Centre where the G20 summit will be held. This was as close as I could get with a camera without staff from Wilson's security jumping on me and moving me on. So it's really, really tight security down there at the moment.
I feel that legislation that has been passed over, passed through the government for the period over the G20 is also dictatorial. If there was a balance in Parliament right now, a lot of these new legislation laws would not have been able to be passed because they infringe people's freedom of speech and people's rights.
Jagera Hall at Musgrave Park is open for business after the Brisbane City Council backed down on closing the building during the G20 for renovations and asbestos removal. Council says the hall is now free from asbestos. Week-long protests start this weekend with the Welcome to Country on Sunday, followed by a protest on Monday against the ongoing removal of Aboriginal children.
I would like to tell the world leaders that this is happening here in Australia and they have no chance. Every time that they go and try to talk to any department here in Australia, the answer is no. So you would understand, as a grandmother in every country, how would you feel if they were stealing your babies?
Other issues to be addressed during the week include deaths in custody, youth suicide, police brutality, native title, sovereignty, uranium mining and gas fracking. And the Brisbane Aboriginal Sovereign Embassy is inviting all our mob to attend.
The unfortunate thing is now we're fighting a terrible system and it's mostly blacks supporting a colonised system. And we want those blacks to be counted. They don't have to come down and be demonstrating with us, but they have to do something for our struggle for justice, because their key portfolio when they get all these big jobs and research money is closing the gap. So they go overseas and talk at all these fancy conferences. You never see them mixing with the grassroots people.
David Little, NITV News, Brisbane.